Hey, what up? This is Eddie 04, and today we'll learn how to set up our PS4 controller on Naruto Shinobi Striker. Now, first thing first, I'll be honest, I have never put that much effort into Naruto to Boruto Shinobi Striker. Probably watch a couple videos and maybe demo the game, but that's about it. Since the community has been asking, I decided to thoroughly test the x360ce controller emulator with a PS4 controller on Naruto Shinobi Striker. I just got one thing to say. The game was actually fun. Probably not as much fun as Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, but at least it's not Jump Force, which I also tested, but I couldn't bother in going through with it. Testing Jump Force was excruciating. Anyways, we're not here for a game review, so let's just go ahead and cut into the chase. So the main reason why we are using the x360 controller emulator is because PlayStation controllers are not natively X input devices to be used on PC. So we need a little workaround to get our game on. So this is what happens when we initially encounter trying to play Naruto Shinobi Striker with a PS4 controller. Regardless of big picture and Steam drivers running, this game wasn't designed for controllers, so it won't work natively without some work. Okay, so we'll start by locating our game folder to add the Xbox 360 controller emulator and set it up. So you're gonna right click on our game in Steam, we're gonna go to manage, and then we're gonna go to browse local files. Now I know I'm currently using the Steam library to find the game folder, but if your game is not running on Steam, the location might be slightly different, but at the end it's the same purpose, right? So now, for the X360 controller emulator files, you can download them from the links in the description below. If you use X360 controller emulator version 4, then you won't need to add anything to a game folder. By the way, check out the card up here to learn to set up any game controller on PC using the Xbox 360 controller emulator version 4. For this video, we'll focus on version 3, which is my favorite method since you don't need to keep the software running in the background compared to version 4. So once we have located the Naruto to Boruto Shinobi Striker folder, we still need to dig a little bit deeper. Just adding the X360 in the folder won't do. So we'll need to go to the binary folders. And for that is in Naruto, and then binaries, then Win64, and the true game executable file is Naruto Win64 shipping.exe. Now here is where you want to drop in your X360 controller emulator. So as you know, you can go ahead and download the files from the links in the description below. And I'm just going to go ahead and drag over my X360 controller emulator. Now here is where you want to drop the X360 controller emulator app and run as an administrator. At this point, it's important to stress that you need to click on create so that the DLL file can be created properly. Now, if your initial installation fails to add the X input file, then I would recommend, you know, closing it and then reloading the software as an administrator to make sure that this prompt comes up so that you would create the DLL file on the installation process. Now from here, we're gonna go ahead and search for the controller settings online, which means that you need to make sure that you have the search automatically for settings option selected, and also make sure that the search the internet checkbox is checked. Then we go ahead and click next. After a couple of seconds, it should go ahead and load whatever it finds in the internet related to the controller configuration online, and now hit and finish. If you have any doubts, let us know in the comments below. As a matter of fact, I read through all the comments and I do my best to reply. Now, as you can hear, that little beep there is actually the confirmation that there is a controller connected to the computer, and it has been detected as an X input device. Now, the fun part, we need to map our game controller. You could go ahead and just try auto, but that option doesn't provide the best experience since the buttons don't match, so I'd rather remap my buttons to the proper setup. In other videos, I've explained in this channel how to map your controller into the X360 controller emulator. You can go ahead and check the card up here. Now the moment of truth, trial by fire.
VR 忍術闘技場を利用するの？ま、あまり力まずに頑張ってちょうだい。
And here's the game loaded on PC, and we can easily use our PlayStation 4 controller. For more awesome videos like this, make sure to smash that like button. Have a PS4 controller and you still want to use it with your PC? Then go ahead and check the video up here. And if you want to watch one of our latest videos, then go ahead and check the videos down here. Now, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click on the notification bell so you can be notified whenever we release a brand new video. This is Eddie04. See you on the next one. Peace.